Spirit of God with evidence of speaking in other tongues. That is our power. Our power will never be sufficient enough on our own. Samson tried it on his own, but the passions of a life got the best of him, and he failed miserably. The good news is God wasn't done with him, but his story could have been so much different. This morning, the things that we wrestle with, we live in a world where evil is exalted and righteousness is punished. So we need men and women who will rise up under the Spirit of God and say, I will stand for God in the middle of an hour that is darkened. I kind of feel like we're almost, Brother Josh, living in the days of these judges, where spiritually speaking it is dark. It's such a compromising day and age. I heard this week, and I've not read the book, I've just listened to a lot of folks who talk about the shack. And while there's so many tools as Christians, I appreciate that we have in our power the message of universalism. The message that takes away that God has sent his only begotten Son. For men to need to be saved, anything outside the blood of Jesus Christ will not bring salvation. So this, Brother Josh, this universal gospel that is being preached, can't send people to hell. It sounds good, Brother Wall. And we like to make people feel good. Who wants to make someone feel uncomfortable? But there's always a consequence to sin. And it has to be dealt with. If it's not dealt with through the blood of Jesus Christ, it will be dealt with through suffering and pain in humanity. Some is experienced on this side of eternity. But if it's not dealt with before the final breath, it'll be dealt with through all eternity. And so we need a church that will preach the gospel without compromise. We need a church that is men and women who is filled with the Spirit of God, that their joy is not based on anything outside of them, but it's based upon Jesus Christ and the Spirit of God on the inside of them. And I'm fearful that the church is falling short of that. So this morning, it's a time for a recommitment. Amen. In the presence of God, say, God, I can't do it on my own. I need your Spirit, your power. My invitation this morning is just to a church who will recommit to the power and the Spirit of God moving in their life. Would you come in and make a recommitment around these altars this morning? Let's get on this morning. Amen. Let's make a recommitment. God, I want your power.